And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube who's watching this video later on for some more Chandra Tribal in Standard 2020. This could be the last time that we play Standard 2020 before rotation on Thursday. And as y'all know, this is my favorite deck to play, so gotta play this one more time. As you can see here, we're not having a stream tomorrow. Also, by the way, the Throne of Eldraine set review is up on YouTube. If you're watching this later and you haven't checked that out, hope you go through those videos. But no stream tomorrow. I'm going to be building decks and getting ready and, you know, just getting other things around the house and everything that I need to do to get ready for the new set, because then whenever the Throne of Eldraine comes out on Thursday, I won't be taking a day off for a while. But then we'll also be having a 12-hour stream there on Thursday as well. So this could be the last time we're playing Standard 2020, so let's get to our deck here. As y'all know, again, this is my favorite deck. This is all we're trying to do is be a red control deck, right? So we're mono red control, using our planeswalkers to win the game and grind out opponents. The two key cards here, which you may not realize, are Chandra's Regulator. Is just really big game, just being able to copy your planeswalker's abilities. It can get you just so much value. And also it helps smooth our draws out. Being able to discard mountains is really important. That's why we're playing so many mountains and not like interplanar bacons or anything like that. Help you smooth out your draws in the late game. And then Novice Pyromancer. This card's really important. The adding extra mana, that -1 ability, add 2 red mana, that is crucial for being able to double spell, be able to play a lot of things, be able to have enough mana to play your planeswalkers and activate regulators and stuff like that, get to these things early. Very important card there. Plus we have the combo kill where we can do 20 damage. If you have regulator and 3 mana Chandra and this 4 mana Chandra, you have these 3 in play and you can activate, you have the mana to activate regulator twice, you can attack for 20 damage. Because since you get to do these twice, you can make 4 2/2s instead of 2, and then you can give them all +4/+0, so that's 20 damage. All right, enough talking. Let's get to the games. We're going to play like 3 of the leagues here. That's what we did with the other 2 decks. Let's go with Chandra Tribal. All right, there we go. Good question. Nice Life asks, what's a better draft format, Core 2020 or Ravnica? To be honest, I actually didn't play draft with Core 2020. I did with Guilds of Ravnica, and I liked Guilds of Ravnica draft. So I assume you're talking about that one, not Ravnica Allegiance. I assume you're talking about those. Maybe you're talking about original Ravnica. There's been a lot of Ravnicas. But Guilds of Ravnica was pretty good. Hello. Killadub. It's a cool name. Yeah, Ravnica, you can focus on the guilds, like Guilds of Ravnica, just focus on the guilds. Draft your guild deck. I feel like this is a flash deck. I feel like this is Simic Flash. Yep, looks like that. So we would like to draw 6 mana Chandra because it's uncounterable. Thank you, Kendis. Forgot to do that. Yeah, we just missed a bounty. We did Walking Dead Season 10. trailer. You're playing BL3? What's BL, is it Borderlands 3? I actually played Borderlands, even though I didn't have any video game systems. I had a friend that had Borderlands 2 and I guess PS4 or whatever was around for Borderlands 2, you know, back in like 2012. And so I used to play Borderlands 2 all the time. I'd go over to his house and we'd play Borderlands 2 a lot. That game was a lot of fun. Man, and so yeah, I bet Borderlands 3 is also really good. I wish it was on Switch, because right now I do have a video game system. I have a Switch though, and it's not on Switch. You know, I checked. It's not on Nintendo, and I'm really sad. Ah, thanks, Bucket Fridge. Welcome to the channel. Glad to have you here. Yeah, I've never done PC games. Maybe I should, but I just never have. Basically playing this because of like a wolf. I don't really want them to play a wolf, you know, if I don't play it. All right, six mana Chandra. Let's awaken the Inferno. Awakened Inferno. Oh yeah. The Inferno has been awakened. Have I seen any broken Mirror March decks going around? Yeah, Samantha's got a broken Mirror March deck. No.
Ooh. No pressure.
Good question. What's the harder flex, the exquisite Chandra sleeves or the Mythic Championship sleeves? Ugh. Worst possible card for us to see. They just don't have an ambusher this turn. We're gonna be doing pretty good.
All right, let's do this thing.
We're still not like doing bad, but could be doing better. If there's another wolf, we're in trouble. By we're in trouble, I mean Chandra's gonna die. If they have like a smaller flash creature, we can flame sweep it.
Let's make some more room to fight in. I've always wanted to make a really big fireball.
So I'd like to be able to play Novice Pyromancer. But then we don't have removal up. So that's really rough. Yeah, I guess I can just chump block with Mobilized District. The only card in their deck that has a chance of beating me is like Ambusher. Like after, you know, playing this card, like where we were was Ambusher. And they not only had one, but had a second. It's unfortunate.
I'm sorry, friend.
Hopefully it resolves. It's a good sign. So this track here, Kung Fu Fighting, this is just like a random B-side on this artist. I can't quite think of his name. I guess I could just look at Carl Douglas. Just a random B-side on a different single, or maybe album, one of the two. But it was something they just kind of, they just needed a filler song basically, in the studio, and they recorded it in one take, and it was just less than an hour. Just, you know, make up the lyrics and throw it together, and then of course it's this huge hit. Pretty awesome. Glad Carl Douglas had that hit and set up for life with that.
Won't lie. I'm a pretty
All right, GG's.
Say hi to my fiery friends. Say hi to my fiery friends.
Lots of fiery friends. But yeah, Regulators is awesome.
It's elemental, dear. What's your name?
Regulator won us this game for sure. You know, got to loot away so many cards, help us dig. All right, we're 1-0. Yeah, just casual 20 damage. Ooh, good matchup. Good matchup here, 265 versus 261. We are very, very slight favorites being 261 versus 265. But a nice, good close matchup here. Flash again. Land. Yay. The most fun deck I've played recently. I really like that Abzan Hero that we just got done playing, and this one too. Honestly, today I played like three decks that I like to play, between Arcbow, and these other ones. I'm gonna try jamming this, see if it resolves. That would be awesome if it does. It did. That was awesome. Here, but it's gonna be fun. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna try something new. Does mean that they have another 2-1. Ooh, no 2-1 also? Wow. So now we get to just add mana and play this Awakened Inferno. Oh man. That is just clutch.
Here, have some of that magic stuff. Time for sparks to fly.
Time to go double emblem.
Get out of my way. I'm burning up here. Hope it's not too hot. Let's get toasty.
Only a sailor, not even a wolf. Jeez. Two G's. I love these uncounterable Chandras. Yeah, Regulator is awesome. Yeah, that game, you see how powerful Regulator and that uncommon Chandra is. You know, like we got to use it as a removal spell and then add extra mana for us there. Hopefully we're playing against a slow control deck, because our hand is really slow. I maybe shouldn't keep this hand with double six drop. They are deciding to start the game with 5 cards instead of 7 cards. That's bold. To farm traditional constructed. I don't know. It's kind of hard to recommend a deck like that, because everybody's like play pattern or like play styles and things like that are different. It's hard to say. There's a lot of decks you can play. My deck? No, I made this deck in Atlantic. Ugin's in the deck to deal with permanents that red decks can't deal with, such as like Cavalcade of Calamity. And and planeswalkers and stuff like that. Like, we've killed large creatures that we wouldn't have otherwise been able to get rid of with it before. So yeah, that thing attacks for 3. I was hoping they would play another creature. Ugh. Maybe I should have just taken the 3. I guess I should have. Longer. Yeah, so this is just Mono Red Cavalcade. I need more mana. Yeah. If I would have just taken the 3, let them untap and play some more creatures, would have been better off. When the Cavalcade deck that mold to 5 still has as many lands as you do. Or when they have more lands than you do.
best pyromancy student.
How are we getting out of this?
Don't worry. I brought company.
If I kill Chandra here, I'm taking... Yuck. 9.
Sit back and watch it burn.
Come on, land. Oh, magic.
Living in a monastery full of firebrands? Don't worry. I brought company. I'm telling Mother Ludi on you.
So I wouldn't mind if my opponent attacks my Chandra to kill my Chandra. Because then, you know, I'm still at 7 and not at 3. Wow. Wow.
Yeah, I like to think on my feet.
That's not bad for me. We don't have the mana to minus 2 in shock.
Don't worry, I brought company. Let's go. I just want to hug all those fire critters.
I was considering adding loyalty counters. I mean, if we draw regulator, we can, you know, just have lethal.
Hey, I'm meditating here. Ooh, hot, 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 hot. Let's make this quick. I've got other things to burn. Utterly is the best way to destroy things. Hey, these little guys are great.
So yeah, like we're still at 7. You know, that skewer going towards me instead. All right, GG's. We drew it.
Hey, don't worry. I brought
company. Wow. My opponent would have just done 4 damage to me with the Chandra could have just done 4 damage to me. Instead of casting the light up the stage, and then like that skewer they get later on, like they probably would have got that skewer in time to kill me. All right, we're 3-0. Chandra Tribal. What a great deck. What a great deck. What a great deck. Yeah, we're getting up there. 154. All right. Next game, same scenario. Let's draw two lands. And then we're good. I like having these removal spells, though. I want to have Coil for, like, Dreadhorde Butcher. Gutter Bones. Ugh. Where's this land at? Land? No. Ugh, this would have been a sweet turn. Like this, that's like a game-winning turn if we draw this land. Hey, Sothian. We had three draws to draw land. I'm playing 25 in the deck. Just needed the one. And then we need one more a little bit later on, but we need one for right now. Come on. Looks like they're just chilling with a bunch of removal over there. Lands and removal, I suppose. Could have a backup Judith. I played 26 lands in this deck in best of three. But with the best of one hand fixing, I cut a land for this format. But yeah, I played 26 in best of three. Yay. So that puts us down to three. It's going to be really tough to beat this Mask of Immolation, but... They really shouldn't play the Gutter Bones there. I guess it doesn't matter. It's because they can only equip sorcery speed. I was thinking they just wait a turn, but yeah, it doesn't matter. Well, darn, our deck let us down this time of not finding the land in time. I like that matchup for us. Assuming we play our lands. Do you like the colorless cycle land in these kind of monocolored decks? Depends on the monocolored deck, basically. I don't like it here because, specifically because of Chandra's Regulator, where I want lots of mountains to be able to discard to Chandra's Regulator. But depends on the deck. There are some good colorless lands in Standard right now. Three is a little annoying. Guess I should have just fired off the flame sweep before, but doing it now, so you know they use that to add black mana. Also, didn't want them to just be able to play Nissa the next turn. Nissa's always a problem. It depends on what you want to do. Interplanar Beacon is better at sometimes, you know, like against like the red burn deck, yes, but against like the other control decks and decks with planeswalkers and things like that, like Mobilized District gives you a pretty good attacker. So it kind of depends. They do different things. It's not. I don't really see one too much better than the other. Basically, I'm using Mobilized Districts because I think we have enough cheap removal to do pretty well against the aggro decks, and I have in the past. I can create or destroy. Here, have some of that magic stuff. But yeah, whenever you stumble against a red aggro deck. And you're trying to stabilize and not have them burn you out, then, you know, Interplanar Beacon is incredibly valuable. But that's kind of about the fabric of the multiverse, kind of about it as far as that's concerned. It's not very valuable all the time. You know, like, Interplanar Beacon's not going to do very much here for this match. But, like, the Mobilized District can block a Nissa land right now. I knew you needed my help. Basically just looking for land. So we're look at the top two, see if we hit a land drop. What's that smell? Oh, this is just going to be bad for you. That's unfortunate. It's not really, it's not really lagging for me over here. I don't know exactly what the lag is that some of y'all are talking about. And this is why Mobilized District is really good. Dragon, that was just... that was just a troll.
There's no problem. Fire can sit back and watch it burn.
Truth lies beyond vision.
Decline. So I could have kept the land in hand and discarded to Regulator, but I honestly don't mind having another land in play. Don't think we really need to loot there, considering we have the Fire Artisan finding multiple cards for us each turn. Alright, so now we feel pretty good about looting away that land. Alright, so we have a backup Pyromancer.
I sure hope you can't handle toast it.
I guess let's see if you hit a land. Decline.
This is just gonna be bad for you.
Darn it. I should have just done that first.
I'm ready to fight.
Ether itself serves.
I'm gonna be starting my stream on for Throne of Eldraine on Thursday at noon Eastern time. I don't know exactly when it'll I don't know the exact time that it's going to be live on Thursday. Hopefully it's live already on by noon. Hopefully.
The undead make great minions. Let's reduce the battle to shambles.
So you only do, like, we can exile 7 cards by doubling up. You know, we can double this Fire Artisan thing here, but we only do we only do 7 damage. There we go.
Oh, it's you burning.
Finally found lethal.
Ooh, I've learned a bunch of new burn spells to try on you.
All right, I'm going to try resetting Arena because it is being really choppy here. So I'm going to try resetting it. Was I just 156 and I won and I'm still 156? Or no, I lost. Or wait, no, I guess I lost and then won. I just lost my last match. Never mind. All right, Mariah, see you Wednesday. All right, let me try something else here real quick too. Okay, I'm back. It shouldn't be too bad at Mayo, like just being able to play on Thursday. I don't think you need to wait till Saturday. So flame sweeps are pretty good against a lot of aggro decks in the format. Hope that's what we're playing against. So what was the lethal? We got to attack for 20 damage that last turn. We had our combo of 3 mana Chandra, the uncommon 4 mana Chandra, and Regulator in play. So we got to make 4 5-1 attackers. I'm playing Gates. Ooh, love it. So, good part about Flame Sweep here is it can kill a whole bunch of zombies, like they're, you know, if they're going Field of the Dead. Gates could be a deck with Throne. I'm not sure. Gates would be the kind of deck that wouldn't really like Questing Beast, you know, a haste attacker like that. Sure, let's do 2.
Sit back and watch it burn. Let's light it up.
Well, we found all of our lands now. I don't know how many lands in a row that was, but it was probably a lot. It was a lot-ish.
Is telling me what to do.
Okay, first emblem achieved.
Hope it's not too hot for you.
So we're doing here is just getting a lot of emblems. Oh no, now that's a huge problem. That's a card that I've just really struggled with these things, like the people that play Agent of Treachery. I mean, it's just
utter cake. Well, that was a tried. Disaster.
That's just really rough. Thanks, Mike. Alright, so we'll see here. I could use another 6 mana Chandra where I can play it and then double emblem immediately. Hey! Mike, thank you so much for the Twitch Prime sub there. My opponent really should not be doing this. First main phase like this.
Sorry, I'm late.
Could have just gone to attacks first. But yeah, they got me here. The Agent of Treachery.
I'll protect you.
Here we go, next one. I honestly felt really, really good about that until Agent of Treachery. That card's rough. Because, you know, we're a slow control deck where that card is just perfect against. I could definitely see, like, with having all the, like, a lot of more tap lands in the format, I think it's very possible that Agent of Treachery becomes a huge part of Standard. And with so many good ways to get more mana efficiently, especially, you know, like your Risen Reef, Cavalier of Thorns, Nissa, that kind of stuff. The Great Henge. The Great Henge just makes you want to play Agent of Treacheries. Makes it a little rough being a Planeswalker deck. Need to make a primarily white deck. For current standard right now, for standard after rotation. Like best of three, best of one, like what, can you give me some more help here?
Need a fire started? No? Too bad. We can do this together.
Okay, for like the daily quests. Just like playing a bunch of white spells. I mean, so yeah, you can go with like Boros Feather. Boros Feather would be pretty good. Or Azorius Skies. Either of those. Yeah, but yeah, you can just play anything that's in your, for the daily quest, you can just play kind of anything that's in your account, basically. All right, looking for uncommon Chandra.
You'll get him, buddy.
I also can't really beat Dracuseth. Okay, well, looks like we're dead. There you go. Thanks, Othian.
I am not happy right now.
So I didn't kill the Tomebound Lich. I saved the removal spell because that removal, the Chandra's Triumph could do 5 damage, and so it could have paired with another, you know, with us finding something else, like the two could pair together to kill the Dracuseth. Okay, 4-3. After starting off 3-0, we've run into some troubles here. Two real downsides of my deck are definitely Dracuseth and Agent of Treachery. Not too much to do there. just play against this. Yeah, just played against our opponent here. I'm really hoping for no Nissa.
You know what's better than having a plan? Basically, fire spreads fast with help.
Crash, yeah. Definitely six mana Garrick. For sure. But not too sure about anything else there, to be honest. For what other cards to put in that deck.
Hey, I'm Chandra. Nice to meet you. I'm getting the hang of this magic thing. There's no problem fire can't solve. Fire spreads fast with help.
Yay, no Nissa.
I don't have enough swears right now.
All right, they killed the wrong one. Ah, guess they killed the right one.
Ooh, hot, 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 hot! Let's make this quick. I've got all my things. Let's make some more room to fight in.
Yeah, the pre-order is worth it value-wise. If you're planning on just purchasing packs to open, I do think that...
I'm good at what I...
It was probably going to die.
I do think that, like... If you're just okay, not even, you don't have to be very, that, you know, you don't have to be that good. You don't even have to really even go 500. You can be even a little under 500. But if you like limited, I do think limited, if you're just trying to, all right, so if you like playing limited, that's like sealed. And you know, you're kind of decent at it, and you're not trying to get specific cards, and you're just trying to get all of the cards in Throne of Eldraine, I think you can do better by I was trying to think about this, but I think you can do better by just buying gems and then using gems for sealed. I think that's a better way to get just kind of all of the cards in Throne of Eldraine than buying packs.
Everyone is expendable.
The audio and video is desynced. I'm going to play... I mean, so I played Abzan Hero earlier. Pickle Bolas. The deck right before this. I'm going to be playing it again on Thursday. I'll be playing it on Thursday during the 12-hour stream, though, with Throne of Eldraine in it for sure there. And so, yeah, really I was saying sealed and over draft because I think sealed is the better value gem-wise. I think it's, you don't really win a lot of gems going with sealed, but you can have your gems last for a while and get you a lot of cards.
Necromancer has a nice ring to it. Rise and shine. Don't dwell on what's about to happen.
Wow, what a draw step. That is so good. Okay. So, we're going to minus two, do two to this. Copy it. Do two to that.
Have to try harder than that.
So Liliana dies at five. Let's go minus five.
Looks like you're on your own now.
Bye-bye. I've got a burning desire to finish you.
All Alright, so Liliana's out here. So we got to get rid of Liliana, make sure they're not ultimating the Golgari Queen, and keep both of our planeswalkers around. With gold, so yeah, the gold, you can kind of go either way with that. That's pretty close, because the gold you can only use for drafting, so I think you want to be, you got to be a pretty good, or like a pretty decent drafter. The thing about like sealed is you don't really have to win hardly at all to make it worth it with sealed. Even if you just go winless, if you go 0-3 with your sealed pool, you're getting just as much value as opening the packs anyway. And whenever you start winning with sealed, you're getting a whole lot more value. What's up, Narinen?
Hey,
yeah, the constructed events that you pay with gold are good values, both the best of three and best of one, depending on what you like to play.
Sit back and watch it burn. This is just gonna be bad for you. Oh, good hit. Me, or is it
I could have gotten rid of my 6 mana Chandra and taken down the Golgari Queen for good this turn by playing like the other Chandra and taking that thing out, but I don't think we really need to. We got 4 emblems now over here. Just make sure this Vraska can't ultimate. Yeah, sealed all loss. Alright, so let's say you play sealed and you lose every single match and you go 0-3. It costs 2,000 gems to do sealed and you get 200 gems back. So you're net down 1,800 gems. For that, you open up 6 boosters, so you get 6 rares, and then you get the 6 boosters for doing the sealed. You also get 3 prize boosters as well. So you get 9 total boosters. Now, if you just buy boosters from the store, they're 200 gems each. So buying 9 boosters costs 1,800 gems. So it's the exact same. The difference there, though, is you don't get... So it is worse because you don't get... you don't get, like, the one extra... Like, you're only counting as opening 3 packs towards wild cards. So you get, like, one less rare wild card, basically. If you go 0-3, you lose a rare wild card. But if you win like any games, you know, you go 1-3, 2-3, 3-3, you start getting those gems back and it makes it a lot cheaper. If you get like kind of fortunate and you open up a good sealed pool also where maybe you go, you know, like 5-3, 6-3, 7-3, you know, you have a really good record, you can basically do that run for free.
Yeah, I call my fists Pyromaster and Firebrand. The city is so constraining. I need to be free.
I'm gonna stick up here. And so there's a lot of variance with sealed, you know, like who opens up better rares, like that kind of thing. And playing limited, playing sealed, playing draft and sealed, I think is a great way to get better at Magic too. That's what I did for, honestly, I just played limited for the first like couple years of playing. I just played tons and tons of limited. I think that's how I really improved a whole lot. Because I think by just playing that, you get better at deck building and a lot of parts of the game, you know, combat and all sorts of things. So what's going to improve this deck? As far as the new set, the only things that are really for this deck are just other red removal spells that can kind of upgrade it. that's really about it. There's not, you know, like, we are just a monocolor deck, so it's, we don't have like a ton of stuff to really choose from, but you know, like, we can, you know, besides just Chandra's Triumph, Lava Coil, Flame Sweep, you know, we can kind of pick and choose other other removal spells depending on what threats we really need to deal with the metagame, kind of thing. I'm gonna bolt the bird. No. Really? All right.
Hey, I'm Chandra. Nice to meet you.
Of course it is, Nissa.
Harness the elements. Close, but you can't catch me.
Oh my gosh. That's a good turn. That's a good turn.
Bad for you. Fight on without me.
Up in flame. Ha ha, toast it.
Well, hopefully you don't have anything else. Yeah, something could probably go for the rare War of the Spark Chandra. Something could probably go for that slot. I don't have a wonderful suggestion, but it's my least favorite of the Chandras in the deck. 4, 5. So we got 5 mana. This Chandra can minus and get back the Chandra's Triumph next turn to kill the Druid. So if our opponent has nothing else, come on.
Dueling you will
so much for them having nothing else. If only I didn't waste the Flame Sweep and only kill the 2-1, and then there's just suddenly two more O2s the next turn. My opponent played around Flame Sweep just absolutely perfectly.
Nature's true power.
I don't have enough mana. Bleh. I guess I shouldn't have played that land. I guess I'm not going to be able to do what I wanted to do anyway.
An Anyone need
just cut that land to be able to discard?
No? Too bad. Go get him, buddy. Oh, they're so cute.
More data will be needed.
Yeah, so Replicator copies the effect, so we could, like, if we do the minus two here with the Regulator, we can, you know, we could minus two for two different spells, but we don't have the mana to cast two different spells. It doesn't cast the same spell twice. All right, so we ended up 5-4 there through three of those events with Chandra Tribal. Still a positive record, a little disappointing. Still a positive record. It's best of one, can be tough. As far as this deck in the new format in Throne of Eldraine Standard, those green deck, like these green cards are really good, you know, and you know, things like Questing Beast is a nightmare. It's four toughness with haste that could just hit me and kill one of my Chandras immediately. That's a nightmare, honestly. Cavalier Thorns, as we saw there, Nissa, Tamio, those things all start with six loyalty. Like if you tick up Tamio, Nissa, Cavalier Thorns, those all start six loyalty. That's really hard to deal with red damage. And now we're going to have the Great Henge that just continues those decks, card advantage and everything. I don't know if we can keep up with the Great Henge, honestly. While this is a really fun deck, the green cards that we have in Standard right now and that we're about to have can be really, really problematic. So we'll see. Frenzy could work. As far as like a sideboard option, it's not something I'd want main deck, but that could be a potential sideboard option for later games to have if you in like control type matchups where you don't need so much removal. That could be an option. There's not many upgrades here from Throne of Eldraine. We talked about like just some different other red removal spells, but that's kind of it. I mean, Torbran. Torbran, I don't think fits in this deck. I don't think this is really a Torbran deck. I think that we may, you know, like we get to play mono color right now with this format here, but if like those green creatures and everything are too difficult to deal with, we may have to go two color and be able to rely on a second color, being able to help against larger creatures and planeswalkers and everything like that. I'm not sure exactly which color that would be. Going with black, you get Noxious Grasp, Legion's End. But you don't get Great Sweepers. Going with white, you get Sacred Foundry and Temple of Triumph, and then you can have white sweepers. But white doesn't have very good planeswalker removal. Has like enchantments that remove planeswalkers, but enchantments are vulnerable. Going with blue, you get better card advantage and you get counter magic and you get Temple of Epiphany. So we'll see. I guess the one card for this, that this deck could use is the new 4-mana enchantment. I can't think of what the name of it is. Honestly, that card, the 4-mana enchantment could be awesome in this deck, honestly. Fires of Invention. This could be a good Fires of Invention deck. Fires of Invention, you can only cast two spells each turn, but casting spells with CMC equal to the number of lands you have is just free. So you can just like discard extra lands to Regulator to help you get gas. And, you know, you don't have to, you know, if you have six lands, you can just play a Chandra and play an Ugin, you know, for free. And then you can use your mana with Regulator to do other things, to, like, double up everything and so on. This could be a Fires of Invention card or deck. That could be a thing. So there we go. That's, again, you know, things to think about there. So if you're watching the video on YouTube, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons over there and leave some comments. Let me know what you want to do with the deck for Throne of Eldraine Standard as well. And then if you haven't checked out the Brewers set review that we did, make sure you check that out as well. All those videos is where we talk in-depth analysis on all 269 Throne of Eldraine cards. Went through them, you know, one by one, from like just the card number, card one down to card, I guess technically 249, because we didn't do the last 20 lands. So hopefully you go over there, check out that discussion. But yeah, that's it here for Chandra Tribal. So thank you so much for watching.